Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to spend a little bit of time looking at the Noco Genius 10 battery charger and maintainer. Now we've got three batteries in front of me. One's in good shape, one's in fair shape, and the other one's in serious trouble. And we're going to investigate how to use this charger and see if it can bring all three of them up to spec. So if you're ready, we'll dive into this project. Just to give you a quick overview of this particular charger, it is capable of delivering up to 10 amps of charging power. Now it can do this for a regular lead acid battery, an AGM, and even a lithium in the 12 volt range. Now in the 6 volt range, it can do an AGM or a regular flooded. Now it can also act as a 12 volt power supply, then it has a 12 volt repair circuit that it can enter, and then beyond that it's got a rescue mode to where it, they say, it's capable of bringing a battery back with as little as just 1 volt, and we have one in that serious need. So let's fire it up, test each one of these batteries, and then see what it can do. Now our battery in the middle, we know it's good to go. It's been serviced recently and just finished charging. I believe it was 2 days ago. But let's go ahead and take a look at it with both our voltmeter as well as a tester. Now she's reading 12.76 volts. That's what you want to see, at least looking at it with a voltmeter. Now let's take a peek at the one next to it. Now this, the story on this one, it has been sitting on a shelf. It's been charged roughly a year ago, and it's just been sitting in a controlled environment. Now I know the voltage on it is a little bit low. But not drastically low. So it's sitting at 11.89 volts. For this one, I think we can just put it into repair mode, or maybe even just charge mode, and we'll see if it can bring it up. The story behind this battery. This was put in service about a year ago as well. It was actually installed in a unit, and then that unit was parked back on the back lot for about a year. And well, we will see. It wouldn't even light up the dash. It was actually in a gold wing, if I remember correctly. Let's see where you're sitting at. All right. 1.244 volts. So we've got our voltages. Let's go with our digital tester from Firepower and really take a look inside to see what we have. We'll start off with our new one. And we want to change that to 8 AGM flat plate. We're going to measure cold cranking amps, 240. Well, let's see what we've got. All right, state of health, 100%. State of charge, 98. 12.65 volts. It's saying it can kick out 455 cold cranking amps. Okay, and rated at 240, so she's overly healthy. Now, let's take a look at our shelf battery and see what it's got left. volts, about the same as our meter. She's out of the vehicle before the charge, and we want to go to an AGM flat plate, 240 cold cranking amps. All right, state of health, 100%. State of charge, zero. 11.79 volts, 185 amps, cold cranking amps available, rated at 240. So she's saying it's good, go ahead and recharge it. All right, last but not least, let's take a look at our really dead battery. And I can pretty much go ahead and guarantee you that this one doesn't have enough voltage to even start the analyzer. And no, nothing there. We saw that earlier with our voltmeter. It was a little over just 1 volt, and that's not even enough to power this tester. So that one's gonna be the real challenge sitting on the table. So let's move these two to the side for a moment. Bring in our shelf battery. And what we're gonna do is hook up our meter so we can watch and see what the charger is doing when it's going through its charging process. Now the decision we have to make, do we put this in repair mode or do we put it in just regular charging mode? But I think she's been sitting there long enough, especially when it said its state of charge was zero. We're going to bring it over into repair mode, which is over here. We bring it across to the lithium, hold it for 3 seconds, then it'll light up the 6 volt and we continue to scroll through the chain till we get over to repair. So 12, AGM, lithium, hold, 6 volt, 6 volt AGM, supply, and then repair. Let's see what she does. There, going into a pretty strong charge mode. All right, this is gonna be a little while. So we're gonna let this thing go through its motions and see where we end up and then come back and test it. So we'll be back in a few minutes. Well, probably a good while. So good morning. Where did we leave off? Well, it basically charged throughout the night. Now when it stopped, I'm not really sure, but this is what I walked into. It's in standby mode. Of course, my meter is off because it timed out. Let's see what voltage we're at. And then we're gonna use our tester to see where we ended up. That's looking promising. But that doesn't tell us the whole story. Let's see what the digital tester tells us. I'm really impressed with this unit so far. All right, out of vehicle, after charge, AGM, CCA, 240. Let's see what you got. Wow. I'm impressed. State of health, 100%. State of charge, 98. That's almost identical to what this new battery was doing. So, yes, it revived a battery that had been sitting on a shelf for a year. But now, let's really put it to the test with one with just barely a volt in it to see if it can do it. Now, we're gonna put it into what they call force mode. And I believe that goes through a cycle for 5 minutes. And after that, we'll try that rescue mode and see what it can do with it. Or repair mode, I think that's what they call it. But so far, so good. All right. Now we already know that this won't even read on a battery that is that dead. So we have to just use our voltmeter to re-verify where we are when we start this process. I think it was like 1.02 volts or something like that in that neighborhood. 1.243. Bad. So let's bring in our charge cables, get it into force mode, and then see what she can do. We should hold this for about 5 to 7 seconds, and then all of the available modes will flash. Now, if that doesn't happen, that means it actually can see the battery, and I can disconnect one of these and show you how to get it in there. But let's see if she'll go. Okay, so it sees it. So let's assume that it's under a volt. So that it doesn't see the battery at all. So to get it into force mode, which will let it go ahead and charge even though it can't sense the battery. All right, see, all the available modes are, they're flashing now, so we could take it over to AGM and it would start forcing it. But it can see the voltage, so there's no need for us to put it into force mode. See, it's going through it as if the battery's connected, or it's not sensing the battery, so it's just forcing it to go ahead and charge no matter what, even though it's not even connected at the moment. And that's what force mode allows it to do. So let's take it back out. And what we're gonna go for is another repair on this one. So let's turn it on, bring it to the end. 3 seconds, lights up the other available choices, repair. Now we're gonna let it run. And I guarantee you, this is gonna be a while. So more than likely, we're gonna see you tomorrow again. But maybe by the end of the day, it may be through, and then we'll retest it and see where we ended up. So until then. All right, guys, it's been a few hours. It has completed its cycle. Let's see if we've got anything. No, it took it from a volt to about 2.6. So not looking too good for this battery. But I've got one more thing I want to try. Just came in today, Noco Genius Pro 25. Big boy, can do 24 volts as well. Let's get it hooked up and just give it one more shot to see if that battery is recoverable. So let's do it. You should see this thing, even has a felt lined carrying case. Feeling working with royalty. All right, big guy. Let's see what you got. Tell you what, the build quality of the Noco stuff is, it's impressive. Really impressive. I like this stuff, if you can't tell. I haven't read through the manual, but I would bet it's very similar to the 10. Guess we'll find out here in a few minutes. All right, so let's bring her up. Ooh, even got a fan on it. Did y'all hear that? All right, we don't want it. We want to go straight around to repair 12 volts. So we'll bring it here. 3 seconds. All right, how do we get down there, guys? This is a little bit different. I bet you it's gonna be 5 seconds. So there we go. Now we've got it set for repair, 12 volts. Hitting it hard in between 3 and almost 16 volts. So let's see what this one can do. This is your last chance. We'll see what it's got. And welcome back. It is now morning. Let's flip it on and see what we got. Actually, I got so nervous when we were charging it yesterday, and I knew I was gonna leave it overnight. I moved it over to a stainless steel cart. because if it was going to have a fit and fall in it, I didn't want to have it do it on a combustible table. I took a couple of temperature readings, and that center cell was sitting at like 135 degrees. I was like, ooh, this could go wrong. But it's still in one piece. It's nice and cool this morning. Let's take a peek and see where we ended up. No go. Under a half a volt. So if anything, you know, it tried and then ended up making it worse. So there's just no way that this battery is ever going to come back. It is heading off to be recycled at this point. So what did we learn from all this? Brand new battery, started the machine maybe two or three times, put in a storage container, extreme cold, extreme heat. Yeah, it was not going to survive. What should we have done? We should have invested in just one of these, pulled it out of the machine, put it on a shelf, and let this little maintainer charger take care of it. Well, there we go. We went through each type of scenario. Brand new battery, one that had been sitting on a shelf in a controlled environment. We were able to resuscitate that one. And one that was just too far gone, even for this big behemoth to try to bring back. Well, if you need any chargers or any other parts for your machine, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions about this video? Leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscription button along with that notification bell. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on or talking about in the future. Well, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.